All right. Welcome back, everybody. This is... There it's live now. Welcome back, everybody. This is Scales of War number 19. We've been... there's been a bit of a delay between this video and the last one because everything happened. So, like, there's just been shitstorm of epic proportions recently in this house, and it's just everywhere. It's terrible. I don't want to go into that on the air. It's kind of a long thing, but yeah. So we've got everybody's back with us, of course. We've got Colin, Doug, Natalie, Tavi, and Dash. Thank you for coming back. This has been just a massive problem recently, but I'm glad we're all here again finally. I think we're ready to start the show up again. Last time we were here, we had basically we only have just the final boss to defeat. Hopefully we can get this taken care of this time. We were supposed to have done this 2 episodes ago, but just time constraints and everything, we haven't had a chance to do that. So yeah, I think it'll be good to go now. It's the beginning of a turn. Let me get my screen share turned on. And that's the correct window. There we go. Present to everyone. And stay there. Okay. So, let's get this going again. First
let's
person
do this.
Like, sorry?
Let's do this.
Yeah. Looks like the first person up to go is Gillon. Do you remember what was going on the last time you were here?
Vaguely.
Let's go over a quick recap then. This is the very last room that you guys need to go into. That much is obvious because there's nothing left in this room to go through. But now you have the task of getting back to this control panel over here. I'll do this thing. There we go. Getting to that control panel and turning it on, which means that Khaled at least has to get up there. Khaled being our NPC paladin that's been following along. And you have this great big Orog standing between you and the control panel. The goal being, once you've got that control panel fiddled with, all these pathways that the monsters that the orcs have been coming through will be sealed off, and Bordrin's watch will be rendered safe for everybody else.
That isn't dead yet, because there's a lot of dead people.
Yeah. I don't even have the dead bodies laying around, but there has been quite a large number of monsters showing up recently. So we need to get this taken care of ASAP, or else it's going to be just mass problems. So yeah, let's start it off. Actually, I think... end of the turn... So at the beginning of the turn... We need to worry about more bad guys showing up. Oh, that'll make things interesting. Okay. So, let's find... Here we are. Had this all prepared out in advance, but...
But stuff happened.
Yeah. Well, at least it's all prepared out in advance. So... Right in front of everybody shows up this new group of what are these called? Goblins?
Orcs.
Orc drudges.
Wimps.
And I
wait, were they the minions
the,
or...?
Yes.
The turn order.
I thought.
Well. No, it's not going to work. Okay, let's put everybody in... the turn order really fast. And... there we go. Gillon, you're still first. You rolled like a natural 20, I think, so...
Yeah, I'm pretty sure I did.
So you're welcome to start or kick this new episode off.
So, before I do start, earlier Colin... brought up a good point. What are we going to do about encounter powers and dailies that we've forgotten whether or not we used because it's been so long?
That is a very, 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 very good question, and I don't
think I remember which ones I've used. I think I've still got Cloud of Darkness with Parry, as well as the daily Go for the Eyes. No, I'm sorry, the daily Trick Strike. I used Go for the Eyes, not Trick Strike. And I think, and of course, I still got all my At Wills. I think that's what I got. I'm not sure.
Okay, let's see.
Ancient board game reference.
The chat log still shows a bunch of stuff showing up here, so...
Yep, including...
Maybe we should just, Well, let's it's been so long, and this is the last thing we have to do. Let's just call it that everybody's got their dailies for the, or at least their encounters.
Okay.
Awesome. Cool.
So we go before
the final boss.
Oh, another question. Are we doing anything after we beat this boss today, or...
Because
I remember this... Are we doing anything after we beat this boss? Because, like, is the RP role-playing continuing after this, or is it the last thing in the whole campaign, Adventures, whatever? Like, are we doing anything else tonight after this boss is defeated?
I'm as confused as Colin is.
I don't know. The internet connection is still failing me horribly. Try typing it out, because it's... I need to talk to Charter and get this sorted. It's getting... I don't know what's going on. Why they keep having this problem? It's nothing else. It's nothing else on my computer that gives me a problem. Oh. I honestly don't know.
That would be a good thing to think about.
Yeah.
I was supposed to have the day off, and then my boss asked me if I'd come in at 5 o'clock, and I was like, I've got other things to do. Yeah, we might be able to start up the next one. I haven't read much about it, but I can go through it real fast. Maybe take a short break between and just, like, start a new episode. But, yeah, we'll figure that out when we get to it.
Anyway, Galan's turn, right?
Yes.
Do the thing, Galan. Do the thing with great justice.
Okay, the light of Moradin shines down upon all of you, granting you all, like, all of your encounter powers back. It's already been more than 5 minutes anyways. And, say...
And the dailies?
Yeah, let's just say the dailies, too.
Okay, so this is one time when the word daily means a good thing for me.
The question of which ones have you used, because it's been so long, let's just say they've all been restored to you.
Okay. So,
there we go. Malik's badass dance restores your abilities. The light of Moradin shines upon you.
Now that I've injected some levity into the proceedings.
So, I'm going to move here, and...
Wow.
Sorry, I'm trying to take this less seriously and, like, just lighten up a bit. Like, I know some of the previous sessions I was trying to be too serious, but, At least my character's kind of... He has an issue with taking everything too seriously, but at least I can be a goof, right?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Anyway, go on. What's the plan? I see a move. What are you doing?
And then I guess I use my standard action to move more.
Go ahead and anything you have to say, say it, but also type it just so that I catch it.
Oh boy.
Hey.
Frickin' typing lag.
Stupid internet.
Yeah. So...
Okay.
I think that's my turn.
We'll move.
Okay, my turn then.
I wish there was a move skip button for each people.
Yeah, that'd be nice.
Advance the turn order on their own. That's okay. Okay, Alec, you're up. What?
This guy.
Oh, I got you. Okay.
And then I am moving. How far can I move? Let's see.
Probably six.
I think it's six, yeah, but I'm making sure. Where does it show how far I can move? I'm not even seeing it on here. How far can I move? I don't even know. Oh, whatever. Let's just say six. One,
six.
Two, three, four, five, six. All right. My turn is over. Fade bite. Do the thing.
Okay. Trying to figure things out. The
thing that makes minions go kablooey.
Yes, that.
It's a good thing.
Warlock Curse is within the nearest that I can see. And now it's blast is within 10 square, so... Okay, that is definitely...
You know what I really want to do? I really want to do my daily knock him off of this platform, like have him topple down here.
That's a great idea.
I'm going to move over to the stairs here.
That's a good idea.
Because I did it to him, like, a week enemy a while ago, like a half a year ago by now, probably. But, like...
I got to pull up
down this area.
Thing and find out how tall these are.
Different area down, farther down. But if I can do that to the boss and make him topple down and land down there, first of all, he won't be able to reach us if he does survive. And second of all, it's a hell of a drop. It's going to break some of his giant orb.
I think each set of stairs is 10 feet high or something.
Warn you about stairs, bro. We'll warn you, dog.
Right. So...
Okay. Well, Warlock Curse here on this guy.
They're minions, you know.
I know. But...
Might as well, right?
Don't forget that each stair counts as difficult terrain, too.
Go for it.
Oh, then I'm just going to here, because...
I think each one of those is 10 feet.
Well...
So...
It's 10 squares exactly, so Warlock Curse and Eldritch Blast on this guy.
Why are you going for such overkill on a minion? I don't get it.
I'm not using any counters or dailies.
I guess you have a point. I don't remember exactly what your moves are. I don't have your character sheet. What do you expect
This
me
is
to
against
know?
His reflex.
Okay.
And I got a crap roll, as anyone who... has played
which guy are you going after?
This one.
On the far left.
And it's against his reflex.
Okay. Versus reflex, eh?
Yes.
Let's see if I have his reflex. I do not. That's okay. I've got a character sheet for these guys. Somewhere. Oh, that's a great roll. That works.
Okay, and this is the damage. Time for some massive damage that is actually a decent roll.
Oh, hey.
That Ooh. Is a very dead minion.
And, using my Rod of Corruption so that every enemy within 5 squares of this guy is now Warlock Cursed.
Ooh.
Oh, so you're going to use it to curse the other two?
That's exactly what I'm doing.
Awesome.
That's exactly why I put the Warlock curse there. And
so. Wait, did it also hit this one?
No.
Dang it.
Is that within 5 squares? No.
Nah.
5 squares, you said?
Yes, within 5 squares, so. And I assume that this one's dead.
He's, like, just out of range. Dead.
I actually have two attacks that can knock enemies around. Low slash and the trick strike. And if I can hit both of them, I can not only I can in a single standard and then a minor action, or minor than a standard action actually, because low slash can only be is only melee weapons. Then I would be able to knock him 2 squares, like, straight into this pit, right fucking here. I'm so looking forward to this, Ned.
Does that count for,
Hang on, if you can knock him 2 squares
over for me anyway.
Does that count for large creatures, too?
It says, one weapon plus dex modifier, which is plus 4 damage. You can slide the target 1 square, and the target is slowed until the end of your next turn. If you're flanking the target, the attack deals extra damage equal to my strength or charisma modifier. That's all it says.
I didn't catch any of that.
It doesn't say anything about the target size. Also, it suddenly looks like half of the people left roll 20.
I think they're still here. I think it just
oh, good. Does that okay.
Mistake sometimes.
Yeah, if you can knock him off of there, that's all the better.
Roughly into here as opposed to on this.
Oh, I should probably mention this might become important for you guys later. All of these platforms, not the ones on the edges. Well, like I said, no, the ones on the edges too. But all the platforms are made of steel grating.
Good to know.
Post. Oh, it doesn't
good
show up.
To know. So if we ever decide to play Portal 2 on this platform, we won't
oh
be able
God,
to.
Oh, God, yes. Portal 2 in a room like this, we could just kill everything with portals. That's thinking with portals. That is
sorry, I've been playing a good amount of that lately.
It's a good game.
Now
classic
you're
game.
Thinking with portals.
Yes.
Space
Core for character of the century.
Haven't met that character yet.
Okay, so is Fabite done?
Yes, I'm done.
Malik, time to smash heads or something. I don't know, just kill the things. Do your meat shield smashing thing.
Arathi, I think you've forgotten to move the turn window forward.
It's showing Fabite right now.
Yeah, move it to Malik.
Yeah, because I'm done.
At least on my screen. Now it's just Malik.
Yeah.
Malik, run in.
Oh,
well,
I'm way
things.
Behind. Oh, let's see here.
Catch up?
Five.
I can't hear anybody.
Well, only Dash was talking.
Let's see here.
Well, first he's moving.
Yes. Does anyone remember what the range on my magic hand axe is?
No, but I can look it up.
Also, wouldn't that go right through Galan?
Isn't it written down on your character sheet?
Range 5, 10. Oh well.
Not very far than
squares.
That's squares, not meters.
Oh,
So it could do that. It's within 10 squares.
Yeah, so that'd be like a minus something.
10 squares.
Probably 5-10 or 10-20, one or the other.
It's 5-10. I found 10. It.
Yeah, it's in range. Barely. As I said in the thing.
I'm going to use that magic hand axe. Where is that goddamn?
Okay, so if it's 5-10 and you're throwing it 45 feet, then that would basically mean that it would be with a minus 2 penalty. But
well, that would do it.
I'd say 36 is good enough.
As would I. I mean, rolled a 19. Rolled a freaking 19 on that. Nice.
So
buries itself in the bag of the minion's head.
Flies over and slices him clean in two, lengthwise, and then reverses direction and whoop, flies back to Malik.
That is a sweet magic hand axe, dude. That's like hella nifty. Alright, so minion. This is the minion's turn.
Wait, don't ties favor the player?
True. Elenwe should go next.
Alright. Well, can I camouflage myself?
Is Malik moving?
I don't actually
Malik did move.
Okay.
I want to use for a minor.
Minor action, okay.
Oh.
I don't have anything for that, so I'm going to end my turn.
Okay. So he is ending his
nice
turn.
Roll.
Okay, so Orc's turn. He walks out and stands right in front of Gilan and slashes at him.
That magic index is really proving to have a nice ROI.
Ha ha!
Ty's favorite player. Nice. It was close, though.
Yes.
That was close.
Guess it grazes his armor and he just sidesteps it barely.
But, yep, Ty's favorite of the player, so.
But isn't it Lenway's turn?
It will be now.
Yes.
But Ty's favorite of the player in Torn Order, too, I thought, but whatever.
Okay. I don't really know what I should do, because I don't know which approach you're going to take.
Well, I'm planning to knock this guy off the ledge.
Oh, okay.
They're planning on knocking him down, so keeping him distracted and keeping him near the ledge in this area.
Okay.
Keeping him near this area as opposed to over here where I can't knock him off a ledge.
Right.
That would be ideal. Okay. But don't get yourself killed in the process. Is my only last piece of advice here, because it would be risky.
If you Natalie, what's going the range of your magic stones?
Huh?
Your magic stones power.
Magic stones. They can move one person.
You have
one.
A chance for stealth also.
Yeah, I have stealth. But I don't think I'm gonna do that right now. I'm gonna use it when I'm right next to the controls, so that I can use them.
No, you.
What, Tavi?
Want her to kill this dude?
Okay. Well, my magic. That dude?
Yeah.
Okay.
That'd be helpful. If you wouldn't, Kalad get him next turn.
Kalad. True.
Kalad, whatever, that guy.
If I kill him, then
Kalad might get up to him, but he has to run, basically.
No, Kalad's right here.
But the thing is,
Cal's right here. The enemy's right here.
Well, the thing is, if I get rid of the Yorg, then Khaled can use like an extra turn move to get up here.
Yes.
True. I still think hindering this guy would be ideal.
Yeah.
I don't know. It's your call.
Yeah, I think we'll get rid of the Yorg.
Okay.
Here.
Is he in range? Oh, right. Moving is a thing you can do.
Yeah. And then I'm going to throw the stones at the orc.
Yeah, if I recall, Linway has, like, really good movement range, too.
Yeah.
I forget exactly how far it is, but I remember thinking it was preposterous.
Range 10, so... Gotta be within 10 squares.
Yeah. I don't...
She was within 10 squares, I thought. She was.
Yeah, she was.
So you could go from back from where you were.
Yeah, that's good enough. Want.
But that's definitely good enough, yeah.
It's going down 20 feet, it looks like, but that's okay.
Okay, so what attack are you using, Natalie?
Magic
stones.
Or 20 feet or 10 feet? No, 10 feet, I think.
Who knows? It's a mystery. The world may never know for sure.
So
anyway. It's dead.
Yeah? Oh, come in. Give me a second. Okay. Yeah?
Yeah. 10. She hit it on a natural 2.
Alright. Is it dead?
Oh, that would kill it, yeah.
Alright, that's what I'm going to do. All right.
Hey. Are you going to try and, I don't know what you're going to do with the orc, or with the Orog, I mean.
Mm-hmm. Big guy. I don't know what to do with him either, yeah.
He is not in range with magic stones.
Yeah. So, I'll just hold position.
He's barely within range, so...
No, he isn't.
He's not?
Where does this ladder go? Where did this ladder... Ah, shit. Where does this ladder here go to?
Oh, maybe he's not. 51. E. Say that again. Say that in text. Oh, that goes up.
Up. So
yes, that's all we know.
I believe that makes it Khaled's turn.
Ah, so it does. Okay. Oh, gotta get my selector back on. So, I gotta pull up his sheet because I don't remember what he has for... Oh, that's just the wrong thing. I can't remember what he has for stats. I think it's probably 4 or 6, but... Doobie-dee. Oh, there it is. 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4. Stop. He's stuck on the stairs. Okay, that's about as far as he can move in one go, and he doesn't have anything he can use to strength.
Okay.
Can anyone heal him?
No, no distance weaponry for him, so.
Okay.
That's maybe someone could heal him.
The next guy's turn.
Oh, the boss enemy, right. Wonder how far he can move.
Not too far.
Okay, that's good. I hope he doesn't get all the way over here. Oh, whew.
He goes there.
That's much better, actually. He's not going to get stuck in a corner where I can't knock him off.
Ooh. He's going to take... Yee. Hey, move.
Hmm?
There's a kitten.
Oh, well, that would do it. Cats are distractions.
Oh!
Pow!
Oof!
Hopefully lives through that, huh?
I hope so. Let's see, he shifts over one in the process of his attack. And...
So that both of those hit, then?
Good
Looks
grief.
Like it.
He's at one.
Oh, no!
Oh, jeez!
Well, that was close.
We're gonna have to throw some heals on him.
Heals on wheels. I don't know why I said that. Gillon, your turn?
Well, first enemy spawn.
Oh, God. Let's hope not. But they probably will, yeah. Hopefully they don't spawn in front of us, because we need to get over there.
Okay. So, that ends the turn. And pow.
Go on, you think you can clear some of those guys out so I can get over to them faster?
Maybe I have need Malik.
Can you do that? I forget.
Yes.
Okay, do that.
But in order to do that, I need to move closer to him.
And then you'll be off by yourself, and, well, Alad is nearly dead. It's a bit of a risk. Honestly, I know what my character would advise doing, which is... Oh, God, that would be mean. But I would say let Gallon help us out and let Khaled do his thing and hopefully not die. That's what my character would say. I'm not sure what I'm going to say. My character's kind of a dick, so... Khaled would serve it as a distraction while we clear our way and move forward as a team. Because you running forward up there and getting yourself killed alongside Khaled won't help, is the point he'd make. But I don't know. I don't know what you should actually do. Because how much can you heal him? Like, by how much? Because that guy can deal out like 30 damage a shot. More,
yeah,
actually.
That's problematic.
How much could you heal him for?
Quarter his max health. Give or take.
Could you heal him a bit and move him backwards towards us? You get him to move towards us? We're out of range of
Kind of?
I don't know. I don't know what you do. Maybe? We need your character sheet. I don't have it. I've only got my character sheet.
Well... I can use Knight's move to give Khaled a move action.
Yes.
That he uses right now.
Where does he move to? I guess it's Rethi's discretion whether he tries to bear a full retreat and hope the enemy misses its attack of opportunity, or if he just shifts and gets barely away.
Yeah, basically.
Rethi's call, because he's an NPC.
I don't know what you said.
Yeah,
like I said, go ahead and type anything out that you want to say to me as well as saying it out loud. Okay.
Is that your standard action or minor action or what,
Tom? It's my move action.
Oh, right. Yeah, that's how that works. Interesting. Rethi? So where does Kalad move to? Rethi?
What?
Where does Kalad move to?
Oh.
Are you reading what Tavi's typing?
Let's see. He would probably try to go back. You could tell him where to go.
Yes.
Well, to be fair, the only reason the guy got a 31 on his roll last time was because it rolled a 19. You know, he gets plus 12 modifier. So I think the safest move both ideas are risky, but if he moves one space back, he will. I don't know. It's your call whether he shifts or doesn't.
He only has one HP left.
Yeah, so getting him far away would be good, but risking an attack of opportunity from running away instead of shifting away, that's a problem. Neither is a good option. They're both just kind of shitty. Risky.
Well, run away so you can fight another day.
Yeah,
well, if he rolls well enough, either he shifts away or he runs away, but either one doesn't get him very far, and he might get attack of opportunity.
If he's out of range.
What?
Well, he's on a staircase right now.
Yeah.
He could shift the square and be out of range of the Falchion.
Right, okay. That would work.
Okay.
And then on his turn, he could run back.
And he's still not in range of my healy thing. So then, I guess I use my standard action to move forward some, and then use my minor action to heal him. Or let's stay there and use Inspiring Word. Khalid spends a healing surge and regains additional hit points equal to that number.
Okay, so a healing surge plus 11?
Yep.
Perfect. Okay, so that's minus one that, and healing surges do a quarter?
Yep.
Of max health?
Yep.
Okay.
I have a plan, guys. I think, I just realized if I could get three attacks in on one turn, if I did a minor, wait, can I use a minor instead of a move?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah, then I could do that. I could do trick. I could do start with a low slash from a minor to knock him, slide him one. Then trick strike is my standard to knock him one more, and then use a minor instead of a move with snapshot, and that would not normally knock him back one. But with the effect of trick strike, if I hit until the end of the encounter, I can slide him one square whenever I hit him. So that would be three spaces I can move him in one turn, if I don't need to move at all, anyway, that turn. So I think that'd be fucking brilliant. I'm going to like this.
So is it Alex's turn now?
I believe... Is it gone?
Yeah.
Right. Well, right for now, though, I'm going to need to move and get this guy out of the way. Oh, shit. Yeah, I'm just going to start by shooting this guy with my hand crossbow with Sly Flourish. I mean, I might as well use that one. He's dead. Actually, no, I'm using him on this guy. Is that all right? I just realized that we used him on the wrong guy.
Okay, so you're killing that guy.
This guy, yes.
He's dead.
Switch to my dagger to my main hand with a minor action. Then I'm running through here. Wait, is that six? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Yes, that is six. I realize this one will get an attack of opportunity.
The stairs are difficult terrain.
I thought that's only going up them.
You're going up them.
But it looks like I'm going down them on the screen. Oh, you're right. You're right, I'm sorry. I guess that would leave me here. Would that...
You still get an attack of opportunity.
Right, okay.
Assuming he wants to use it, of course.
Does he use the attack of opportunity on me?
Well, you haven't left his threat range yet.
Okay,
it's when you leave a threatened square... Not their threat range.
Their perimeter? Is that what you said?
No,
he said a threatened square.
Not necessarily their range.
Oh, I gotcha. Yeah, he would try to attack.
Let's see if he hits.
Ooh, that actually hit.
5 damage. Shit. Whatever will I do? Yeah, I can't use Swift Parry to get out of that, because that would not work. Because I would need to get more than three, be like within three of him missing. But he's hit me pretty solidly there. Anyway, that is my turn. Fae Bite.
All right. Yeah. I would really like to go after the Orog. However,
these guys are in the way.
Right. So.
Need to move up.
What I'm going to do. I can't even get away to... I would AoE these two down, but doing that would hit Malik also.
Could you hit here? Could you strike here for a radius of larger...
No, it's a burst one. It's close burst one.
Oh, well, I would then I recommend we don't go for it then, because
right,
these guys are chumps, and Malik's kind of important to the game.
Well, if it's a close burst one, if you're standing here, you could close burst this square, and that would hit the other guy.
Aha!
Or no, it's around you, never mind, I'm sorry.
Yeah.
Ignore me.
Yeah, we really want... I mean, that would get rid of both of these guys, but it would also attack Malik, which we don't want.
Well, what stat does it attack? What defense does it hit?
Fortitude.
Shouldn't Malik's fortitude be, like, really good?
19. It's 19.
That's pretty solid, but it's not like
I'll leave it up to you, Dash. I mean, if you're not willing to take the attack, then I won't do it.
So what is it, Dash?
Fortitude is 19.
No, I mean, do you want him to use the attack or not? We know what your fortitude is, but he's asking you if you're okay with him using that attack or not.
Yes, go ahead.
Okay, so I'm going to move here. I'm going to cast Other Wind Stride, which will hit both of these things and Malik, so I'm going to...
As long as it doesn't slide Malik off the cliff.
No.
That would be bad.
Okay, here's my attack roll, which... Would miss Malik, yay! Would it hit these guys?
You attack each one, you roll the attack for each
okay,
one.
Okay, so each now I'll roll the attacks for the enemies.
Okay.
12 on the left one, and 15 on the right one. Those are both against Fortitude.
Okay. That's for Fortitude?
Yep.
Yes.
You hit one.
Okay, so I'll roll the damage. Eight damage.
Which one had the 15? This guy?
That guy.
Okay.
And I teleport 7 squares. 4, 5, 7. I'm going to Warlock Curse the Orog. And I'm going to use my action point.
What are you doing to that guy?
Going to throw a witch fire at it. This one's against Reflex. 28 versus Reflex on the Orog.
Ooh.
That should hit.
Nice.
That
hits.
Okay.
And I think they have something that affects damage on action points.
Yeah, I think you do.
Well, this is not counting it. 21 damage, and the Aura gets a -2 penalty to attack rolls until the end of my next turn.
-2 to what?
Attack rolls on the Aura.
-2 attack bonus. Nice.
And the 21 damage. All but 7 of that damage is fire.
And add 2 to that damage.
Okay, so 23 damage. 9 of that damage is normal. The rest is fire.
Is that 23 damage?
Yes. Yep.
Okay.
I have a feat.
See?
He's pretty beefy, so that's not going to do much to him, but...
Something.
But the -2 penalty to attack rolls will.
That will help.
Also, everyone's got a +1 buff.
To what?
To
buff to what?
I think it's two attack rolls.
Right, okay.
That's a plus one attack, plus one defense. I remember that.
Okay, so does the 13 hit this guy's fortitude? Because I did not add that in. I know that the 12 does not hit Malik, which is good.
Yeah.
Does 13 hit this?
No. I was just checking that, too. You said it was okay. Fortitude, right?
Yeah. Yes.
Yeah, I was just checking that, too, and no, it doesn't hit.
All right. Well, all right. I took out one of the Malik's little guys and took a bite out of the big guy.
Yeah. Okay, Malik, I think you're up.
Okay. Well.
Hit it before moving. Hit it before moving.
Okay.
Why, mask?
Because
so he doesn't. Oh, right, it used its reaction already.
Do you only get one reaction a turn? Like.
One reaction a round, yes.
Round, yeah, that's what I mean.
Oh, okay.
Rathi, how much does that orc weigh, that goblin?
The goblin? Or
yes,
the orc?
It's an orc.
The guy next to me, the enemy next to me, the tango.
Let me think. Medium natural humanoid, probably about 5 feet tall, probably really beefy because it's an orc, I'd say... roughly 10 stone? 200 pounds?
Sounds
fair. How many pounds?
200.
Probably about 200 pounds.
Okay, 200 pounds is my normal carrying capacity. Do you think I can lift and throw him?
I like this idea. Your... this is a preview of things to
you're
come.
You're going to have to do an opposed grapple check, but...
oh, God, if he throws you... if he manages to push you out, you'd have pushed you down...
today.
Oh, God.
I feel great concern for a lot of people. Not that handbook. What the hell?
What do you mean?
Malik ever gets it in his mind to start throwing stuff.
I think you just gave Malik the idea.
Well, the point is, there's a convenient pit here. My concern is if the orc fights back and actually throws Malik down, that would be the problem, as far as I can tell. If the orc wins the roll by a critical and Malik would just fall to his death.
Well, it wouldn't be death. It's only about 40 feet, but...
well, he's wearing heavy armor and he'd just crunch on the ground, wouldn't he?
Why is it grapple?
To avoid that eventuality, I'm going to square.
Go what?
I'm shifting inward to avoid being, you know, dropped in case I fail.
Good thing.
Are you seriously going to try to dump the orc off the edge?
No, I'm going to try to throw him at his big buddy.
Oh, that works.
I don't think you can throw that far. At least not a 200-pound object. Jeez. I mean, orc, not object.
I think it might be simpler to just kill it and move on.
I agree.
Or to dump it off the edge.
Yeah, dump it off the edge would be pretty funny, I'll admit that.
Well, considering the fact that Malik can lift up to 1,000 pounds, that orc weighs 200, and I have an improvised weapons homebrew feat, I think I have a potential opportunity here to be much more effectively removing one goon.
Well, I think you could probably throw him at least this far with all that, maybe, but you're not throwing him this far. No.
You run a bit.
Okay,
besides,
that's Dex, right, Rathi?
Say that again.
Huh?
Dexterity?
Besides, I think that orc deserves the very same fate as Darth Malgus.
I'm looking for...
Natalie's got an idea. Natalie's got an idea. There we go.
But you already used your move action to shift.
I'm looking for grabbing right now.
No, he said use your action point, I think.
No,
move action, yeah.
Which is already used.
This is thrown off the ledge, please. It would be hilarious.
Yeah, then he'd get the very same fate as as Darth Malgus, which is dying
Give him a Disney villain death. They always fall to death for some reason.
Yeah, that's what happened to Darth Malgus in Old Republic.
I believe you.
Actually, that's what happened to the Emperor in Return of the Jedi.
Yes, that's true too.
Standard action is grab.
And same with Darth Maul, except he did it in two pieces.
True.
Here we go.
I don't know why I remember that. Episode 1 was terrible.
According to the player's handbook, grabbing as a standard action is a strength attack. Make a strength attack versus reflex. Do not add any weapon modifiers. You must have at least one hand free to make a grab attempt.
Do you have a hand free?
I'm pretty sure he does.
Yeah, I think you're right. I don't know if he actually has a shield.
Direct from the player's handbook.
You can use a returning magic weapon can either return to your hand or to the ground at your feet, depending on how you want to handle things, but
do you have a shield, Malik?
Okay.
Your shield is
Yeah, you can do the grab attack.
Go for it, man.
It's supposed to be a standard action to move a grabbed target. But you have an action point.
True, you could use your action point to throw him off a cliff. Can we get on with him?
I'm going to be using the action point, yes.
This is going to be badass.
Roll bonus on 20 is like 5, I think.
I'm pretty sure it's 5.
5.
5, indeed.
Probably plus half level, so total of plus 8.
8? You said 8?
Including half level, yes.
Oh yeah, plus half level, so.
Ooh.
Well.
That's versus reflex?
Yeah.
That's reflex.
Yeah, what's its reflex?
More than 10, probably.
It's a goon.
Yes, but I'm going to allow it.
Okay.
This is for creativity's sake.
It's really close, and, you know, I want to see this, so.
And I did build the hand axe so that I could have both hands, so I guess that's where the bone is.
Yeah.
All right, now I'm going to use my action point, and I want to...
Off the edge.
I basically want to execute a charging spear throw type maneuver.
God, you're going to hit Galan in the back of the head with him.
And charging gives me plus 2. So if I move up here, and then I throw it, that should be best for range. I don't know what to roll for using an orc as a weapon, though.
What do I roll for to throw? What's the damage on a thrown orc?
Damage on a thrown orc would be a dead orc.
You need to submit that to out-of-context D&D.
Wizard to the coast?
No, to the out-of-context D&D.
I actually had a friend who
what's the damage on a thrown orc?
Had to ask the question, what's the damage on a thrown farmer?
What's the damage on a thrown orc?
So, let's see. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. That's enough to hit. Pow. And it would be the same as your thrown attack.
And he fall. And I imagine the orc will fall down here after hitting the guy, right?
I think if we win this battle, I'm going to start having him go by Malik Orc Thrower.
This is going to be a great fight.
So, do we have a dead orc and an injured orc?
Do what?
I don't think it did much damage, but, like, it's certainly going to kill the minion, that's for sure. But are we moving on? Like, is it dead?
I'm going to call that throwing the orc is going to do damage to both the orc and the Orog equal to your basic ranged attack.
My basic range attack with the hand axe is 1d6 plus 6. For damage. But that has the magic bonus on it, I think.
So remove the magic bonus.
So that would be 1d6 plus either 4 or 5.
I think
so. Go
4.
Ahead and roll to see if you hit the Orog. You won't get the plus 2 magic hand axe thing, whatever you had. But,
it's only plus 1.
Oh, roll plus 1. Hit. Well, you will get a plus 1 for being plus 1 right now.
Oh, so it's just the same as the magic hand axe then?
Basically. So you could probably just roll the magic hand axe attack.
That was well played.
Okay. So, the orc is definitely dead, and the Orog is going to take 17, that's max damage.
Natalie, I think I know what you should do next turn.
Me too.
Seal the tunnels.
Yeah.
We want to keep these minions from ganging up on us further. They're wasting too much of our time.
We're at a great advantage right now, and we don't want to lose it. You're right.
Exactly. We can totally take this guy.
Of course, on the other hand, any battle I can walk away from saying I threw an orc in a bigger orc is a win in my book.
You have a point. You have a point. I don't know why with someone on the character shenanigans.
So
probably because you
roll damage again for the smaller like, one.
What?
Or are you just counting that one as dead?
The small one's dead, it's a minion. The bigger one is what takes the damage.
What was that? Ah. I need to,
Elenway. Natalie. Hi. Shut off the tunnels.
So I can move 13, right?
What?
I remember she could move preposterously far, okay? I didn't remember how preposterously. Jeez.
I don't know how far I can move, actually.
I think it's like 8 or something. Okay. Anyway, you're well in... You can totally get to the controls.
Okay.
So move over here, or maybe, yeah, it works, and shut down these gates if you can.
Okay. I do that.
Does she know how to do that?
Well, it's a skill challenge, dungeoneering or thievery.
Oh, great.
But you get a +5 bonus to all checks related to the skill challenge. Because Khaled's still alive.
Alright.
Okay. You probably want to do Dungeoneering, because that's based on Wisdom.
Yeah. I have huge
and wisdom. You have preposterous Wisdom score.
She is the wisest of them all. Someone wiser than my character. My character is just a wise ass.
So, how would I roll for that?
What's your wisdom score?
21.
Jesus!
So, D20 plus 13.
5 plus, yeah. D20 plus 13.
Slash roll D20 plus 13.
Okay. Does that do it? Rassi?
To do... Oh. That add the plus 5 in?
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay, we'll call that a success.
Yay!
Go ahead and try again.
Alright.
You can just press the up arrow.
Again?
Okay.
So I guess that's another success. Each roll is 3 or less to screw this up, I guess. Maybe even a 2 or less.
And what else did I roll?
Same thing again, I'm guessing.
Go again.
See how many times you can get it right. Okay, that is weird. 3 4s in a row? That's bizarre.
One more.
There's another 4 I'm calling shenanigans.
Death yeah. comes for you.
Yeah, I mean, and that's the Chinese... number of death, right? 4?
Yeah.
Thankfully, we're not Chinese. We're in fantasy place land.
I hope it doesn't mean anything in real life.
No, I wouldn't worry about it.
I just rolled that for fun.
So wait, how...
Okay, so that's a fail. You have to have 4 successes before 3 fails.
Okay.
So roll another.
So we're at 3 successes, 1 fail.
You win.
Nice.
I think that succeeds.
Oh yes, I think so too.
Okay.
I mean, no more Orog?
Not quite.
No more enemies.
No, I think it chopped off the minions.
So at this point, the control panel shifts into place with a click as her hands, guided almost by the power of Moradin himself, manipulate the correct valves. And
oh, so it's no more little
as
guys.
As she does so, the bottom level of this room, or the main door out down here, has a steel door go foo and slam down over the door itself, creating a barrier that you can't break through, and water starts to flow in from the central pillar at the bottom. So,
wait, what?
But you know that by the end of this turn, this entire lower level here is going to be flooded with steaming hot water.
So basically, we need to kill the big guy and climb the ladder out.
We're going to boil him alive. I like this. Khaled's turn, right? Or you got something else to do?
Sorry, just making sure I had everything right.
Wait, do you have anything else to roll anyway?
Khaled is out of range. And first thing he's going to do immediately is use a... hitting my microphone. Hold on. First thing he's going to do immediately is use his second wind. So that's going to drop him another healing surge. And he's going to gain a quarter back of his health, which was, I think, 13. Whoops. So, plus 13.
Yep.
He's also got a plus 2 to defense, I think it is. Is it a plus 2 to defense and attack?
I'm checking.
Let me look it up.
Plus 2 to all defenses. Just defenses.
Okay, so plus 2 to all defenses. And, let me just zoom in. Three. There we go. Okay. And then he's going to step back, here, I think, because that's going to help him out a little bit. And, wait, where'd it go? Okay. He has, God, Cat, I love you, but get away. I can't speak with you. He uses his daily and, casts a sacred circle, which, let me get the draw out, is a 1, 2, oh, hang on. Dang cats, get out of my way. I don't care. Move. Get out of my way. I can't.
This next turn, people please leave me a space to get in close.
I will. I'm going to try and push him farther away. Next turn, Gillon, use your next move action to move me closer with that thing, okay?
Can't do that.
Oh, encounter?
It's an encounter power.
Dang it.
Okay. Sacred circle. It's not really a circle because the wall's there. But, any allies like, in the square?
Looks more like a rectangle, but whatever.
One power bonus to AC.
Oh, nice. That's it.
Cool.
Beyond what we've already got, anyway. Yeah. Anything else?
Okay.
From him?
So that's going to end his turn. And now... Whoop, rid of that. And now... Tusk gets his turn.
Tusk. Is that his name?
His name is Tusk. One. He steps just inside. He can't go any farther because he's got a short move and he's a big guy. And so, yeah, he's just going to stand right there. And
okay.
That actually puts Khaled back within his threat range. So...
Oh, God damn it.
Yeah, he's got to reach 2.
Shit.
Oh, wait.
And...
If...
Pow. Dice spam. And everything failed. So the second attack shows up.
I think that is a nat 1.
He makes his first attack, so the second attack doesn't count. So he actually swipes over his head, probably because Khaled is short and standing on stairs.
Nat 1s.
Yeah.
Excellent.
He's off balance.
I'm sorry, Rethi.
How about that? He's off balance.
What does that do?
I'm sorry for passing the crap roll disease to you.
Do what?
I said I'm sorry for passing the crap roll disease to you.
Don't apologize. It
don't
was
apologize.
Entirely
you want that.
Scary. Right, so. Okay.
That's the end of the turn. The water level in the area has reached this lowest thing over here. I'm going to drag your attention to this thing for a second where the ladder is no longer there, although it appears to be. And a door slams down shut over this right here.
So there isn't anything coming out of that anymore.
Do what?
There's nothing coming out of there anymore.
Well, there's 6 passages in total.
I said there's nothing coming out of that passage.
But,
okay.
Over the lowest tunnel. And the water level is now covering that tunnel, which means that everything on this level, try that again, everything on this level up until this set of stairs right here is now covered in water. And the water is steaming hot.
So, yeah.
Please tell me we don't get total party wiped. If that catches up to us and he's blocking the way, we should have waited on that thing.
So basically, we should treat that water as crud.
Crud, yes. Key term.
Anybody with good, with keen hearing can particularly hear from right here the sound of pounding and orcs screaming as they are boiled alive.
Hey.
Oh, boy.
So, Galan, you're up.
So what does him being off balance mean?
Not much, really. I mean, he swipes and he misses and he's kind of teetering, but he's a big guy, so you could pretty much attempt anything, but it maybe just like a minus one to his defense rolls. Against the next attack, so your attack basically will have...
How long is he off balance for? Because I intend to use this to my advantage ruthlessly.
Well,
will he be on my turn?
Let me think. A round is only like 5 seconds, right?
Something like that.
Yeah.
That sounds right. So probably about this round.
That makes sense.
So yeah, minus one for his defenses. I have become a pillow.
Puppy again.
This animal is mischievous.
Also, can he do attacks of opportunity while he's off balance?
No, I would probably think not.
Okay.
He needs to have both feet planted to use his weapon, so.
I would really like for Alec to be in range for this, but...
What?
Well, I'm going to move up. So I'm right the fuck next to him.
Well, oh dear. Tommy,
you can't
cursed.
Hold your turn until Alec moves.
That's a good idea. That could work.
Right, I can do that.
Plus, that'll give me the opportunity to hit the Orog with Prime Shot.
Do you want to do that? Alec is right behind you in the turn order.
I'm going to delay until after Alec moves.
Okay, so you can set an action to trigger on Alec's movement.
Okay.
No, I want to, like, take my turn after his.
That's what he said, yeah. That's what he said, yeah.
Not quite.
Whatever. So is it my turn?
Yeah.
Two move actions, so that uses my standard. But one, can I make one of those standard actions be... I know what I'll do. Two standard, so move, no, I'm sorry, move, standard, action point for, let's see if I can pull this off. So I roll well here, I might just win. Like, trick strike, until the end of the encounter, I can side target one square whenever I hit it. So I'm going to try and trick strike it. That is a,
quite understand what you're saying myself, but when you're done explaining it to the audience, go ahead and type it out. Trick strike?
Okay, so... make your attack roll.
Oh.
Well, I need to make sure I know what I'm... Okay, plus 11. Okay, plus 11. Okay.
Did you add the plus 1 from whatever weird blessing thing we have up?
And what about the thing that's on me? The plus 1 from that. So is it plus 2?
I think that is the blessing thing.
What about... Oh, yeah. The thing Fae Bite did is only for AC. Right.
Yay!
Let me see. I lost my... And that's for AC?
Yes.
Yes,
I think so. Yes. So I will first slide it to... It doesn't say which direction I slide it, so I'm assuming I can slide it any direction. With how I hit it, depending on the angle, I guess.
Is it slide one square?
Slide one square.
Sliding is in any direction.
So I'd like to move it this way. And then... minor action time.
Now he's off balance because he's teetering on the edge of the freaking platform.
All right, let's see. Snapshot. Let's see if I can hit with this. So I'm going to just use another snapshot macro, but it'll be plus one beyond this, I think.
Hmm.
Oh! And there we go. There we go. That is one giant orc thing. Monstrosity.
Yay!
It's fallen into critical. The boiling water. That is a cooked orc.
Whop. Okay, so yeah, he falls down.
Yay!
And we said that was, what, 40 feet? Is that right?
Huh?
Don't remember how many feet it was, but it was pretty far.
It's 80 feet.
It's pretty far into boiling water.
5, 10, 15, 20, 25,
30. Oh, also, I forgot to roll how much damage I do from the trick strike. Because that should do 3 weapon plus dex.
Weapon plus dex?
Yeah, it's a daily.
D8 plus 4. Okay. Falling. You take 1d10 damage for each 10 feet you fall.
So that's how 20 plus 13.
So he fell
from
35
that.
Feet, so we'll say 3d10 damage.
And into boiling water, keep in mind.
Into boiling water, which is another... hang on. It's actually extra damage, so roll that first. And then...
Nice.
All right. So 21 down from that, 20 damage from this,
okay,
and 13 from this.
Basically lots of damage.
Yeah, it looks like 54 is what I'm seeing.
2d8 plus...
What about the boiling water, though?
Actually 56 because of the feet I have.
Right, okay.
Okay, so he takes a total of 33 damage from that fall, and now he's in boiling water.
And plus the 13 and the 20 from the actual attacks I did on him.
Yeah, plus the attack itself. So
both attacks.
Minuses on me real fast.
So 13 and 20.
Minus 26, that was the damage, right?
Yes.
No, that wasn't the damage. That was the attack to hit. So... oh, wait, hang on.
So how much damage would you add from your thing,
Tari?
Minus
69 in total.
I'm. Which of those rolls is the damage? Does that include the boiling water in the fall?
Yes.
Okay. So that's bad. He's not bleeding because he's been cauterized. Definitely.
A lot of damage.
Yeah, he's not gonna survive much longer, I don't think. Yelan, you skipped your turn. If Alec is done, you can probably take it now.
Yeah, I had been thinking I was gonna do a thing to buff our future attacks, but that doesn't seem to be an issue anymore.
I feel like doing a victory dance. So that was amazing. Beat that, Malik.
Okay, so the Orog is dead.
Is it?
Well, basically.
I mean, it can't climb out very easily, can it?
Probably not. That's my guess.
So that's one move.
Yeah, Feybite is going to run to the ladder as quickly as possible using double moves. So.
Hey, that's my turn.
Yeah, since the Orog is in the water.
Feybite's turn.
4, 5, 6. Wait, no. 5. Except the wait, are the stairs 2 moves?
Yes.
2, 3, 4.
Each stair counts as 2. Don't forget that.
7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Okay. So I am double moving to go here. Turn.
So Malik's turn now.
Dash?
Yeah.
Can barely hear you, man.
Okay.
You're very quiet. Okay, I can hear you now.
Get to the chopper!
Get to the ladder! Seriously, though, your turn. I advise you beat that. And no, don't jump into the water. To beat it up further. The water will do its job. Shit, he's going to, isn't he?
No, I don't think he's quite that stupid.
I hope you're right.
Or that zealous.
I mean, the water is gonna die.
Well, yeah, he has to circle. He has to go all the way to the staircase to get out of the water in the first place.
This guy that can't climb up the wall.
There's nothing to climb up.
That's what I thought, yeah.
How far down is he? Can I reach his head?
No.
No, he's fallen 35 feet.
And has landed in boiling water. So I imagine his legs will collapse and then he'll just fall face first and boil alive.
That water is still rising.
And then boil dead. Yeah, just get to the ladder, dude.
Boiled orc.
Just get to the ladder.
Wait, you can use a ranged action.
Yes.
Alright, so I am going to use my hand axe again.
Okay. Are
you gonna add insult to injury?
Well, you are such a kill stealer.
Is it putting him out of his misery?
I think he probably just wants to kill it faster.
That's a fair point.
That'll be my turn.
14 damage.
All right. If that's the end of your turn, then it's Ellenway's turn.
Okay, should I just go up the ladder?
Yes.
You probably should.
Okay, so I go up the ladder. See ya, people.
You're gonna catch up. Climb the ladder?
Yeah.
Okay. This is going to sound really stupid. Roll me a d20 athletics check.
Okay.
Why? Is there an at one risk?
It's basically just a pass-fail, because I think your athletics is probably higher than the check it wants, but...
D20?
No. Aww.
Okay, so
balls.
You stumble on a rung. The bottom rung snaps off, and you stumble and fall back down. But you don't take any damage, because you didn't go very high.
Okay, great.
Thankfully, it was only the bottom rung.
I ask for a pass-fail, and it's the 1 in 20 chance to fail, and you fail. Oh, well, that's okay.
Thankfully, it wasn't anything important. Like, just, the ladder is still
okay,
there.
Okay, Khaled's turn.
In one piece.
Khaled, in his best Schwarzenegger impersonation, without realizing it, says, "Get to the ladder!"
I already said that.
I know. That was me, though.
Okay.
So there's one turn, and then... there's another move. He takes a standard for a move. And Tusk boils. And, okay, his the giant Orog chieftain bobs to the surface, has enough breath in his lungs to scream out, "Aah!" And then falls back dead.
I call.
I'm
very pleased with how my strategy worked, aren't you guys?
Yeah, good job.
I'm very pleased with that strategy.
That was a pretty good motion, though, I gotta tell you.
Yeah, I mean, one thing, I admit I'm not always good at the role-playing in this game, but the tactics of combat, I got that down.
Yeah. So.
Oh, God.
You're not done yet.
Yeah.
Three more orcs show up behind you.
Well, more encouragement to get to the ladder then,
Hey.
Oh dear.
What?
Dylan?
Yeah?
Call evens or odds?
Odds.
Moment of truth here, people. I don't know what this is for, but it's a moment of truth. Okay, it's a 16.
No,
that was the last thing.
No, just pick. Evens or odds?
Odds.
Okay.
I said evens before, but okay.
No, I didn't.
Evens. So, this guy who rolled a natural 20 first.
Oh, hell.
And... hooah!
I think I still have a craw hand, my dagger in one hand, so if he... that'll hit, though.
Dang, this guy's lucky. He wasn't stuck behind a closed door. Oh, and, I almost forgot to mention, the water level is now at this height, and a door slams shut across that pathway. So yeah, the orc slashes and hits Alec for 5 damage.
Okay. Is it my turn? No, Glon's turn, right. I can use the orc.
Now.
Okay. Two, three, four. So I'm going to move here. And I guess wait here to make sure everyone makes it out alive.
Oh, thank you.
All right, my turn.
That's how I roll.
That's why he's the leader, I guess. Low slash, which is a minor action on this guy.
Okay.
He's dead, right?
Yeah.
And then I will one, two, three to here.
He falls off into the water.
And then I think I have to go one,
two more to
here. The smell
of boiling orc is becoming predominant in this chamber.
Oh boy. I think that's as far as I can move.
He's going! You must be able to move further than that.
I used... Oh, yeah, you're right. That was one move. Six is my movement for one move. Right, I keep forgetting. I don't know what I was thinking. Yeah, so I guess I can also go to here.
Right, that works.
Right. Okay, that worked.
Okay, Malik, you're up. One, two, three, four, five.
Sorry, what? Can't hear you well at all, Dash.
And I don't have anything to attack, so that's it.
You can use your standard action to move more.
You'd have to be here because of the stairs.
You might as well move here, though, right? I mean, you might as well.
You can move here, too. You don't have to all be in a line.
Dash?
I'm not gonna use my standard action this turn. I don't think it's in Malik's nature to run to the front of the group.
It's okay. Not Malik's nature to run to the front of the group.
I don't get it. There's a joke here, right, Dash?
I missed that.
Calm thoughts.
Huh?
Calm thoughts.
Yeah, okay. But you gotta admit, it was funny.
Was it even a joke? I thought it was serious, somehow.
Yes! That makes it funnier!
Okay, sure. Okay, so Fae Bite's turn.
How many times has Malik just charged in?
I'm just gonna do another double move to try and get the heck out of here. I'm just going to go up the ladder, actually. Up here and out. Alright. So where do I move my token?
Well, first you have to make an athletics check for some reason.
Yeah, you got to make an athletics check.
Alright, I appear
probably
to have...
Probably just a pass fail, but...
Alright, here's my athletics check. I believe it's a plus +3.
Yeah, you can make it.
So I'm out. I'm out.
I'm gonna move you out of the playing field for the moment.
That's fine.
You climb the hatch, and you notice that at the top there is a stone door, trap door kind of thing.
Yeah.
Propped up against one wall of the room that you're in now. And yeah. There's a button next to the trap door.
That'll probably close it.
Probably.
Yeah, so don't push that yet.
Yeah, I'm not gonna push it.
You can intuit that from the design.
So, wow, those things can move.
This guy runs up behind, takes a double move, but he can't attack because he used the double move. Ellenway, you can try the ladder again if you want. Just don't roll one.
No, nat one. That's what I'm praying for.
The ladder's just too slippery for you.
What?
Well,
can't
that,
quite
that's
make it up.
An unadorned four. She adds at least half level to
it's
that.
It's a DC 5. I'm going to give you that much information.
Yeah. So that makes it.
What is your
Well, you add half level to it, which is 3.
Oh,
so
and
that
it's
already
acrobatics, it. So yeah. Okay, so you make it up.
Yay!
Okay, so we'll pull her off one side. You notice the same thing that Fabite just saw, that this is a room that I'll describe the room a little bit later, of course, but...
Chillin'.
Okay, Khaled's turn. gonna spin around and holy strike the orc. Oh, I didn't catch that. That's okay, it's enough to kill him. Knocks him off the edge.
Okay.
And then spins back around and 2, 5, runs forward. And then, yes. 1, 2. Three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Double move, but can't attack. End of turn. And the water level has now reached this. A door slams down, and behind it, just anyone who can see that door from where you're standing can see orcs rushing up the chamber just as the door slams shut, and then they scream and start boiling too. Gilan, you're up.
I'll wait until the end of the round.
Yeah, that was the end of a round.
Yeah, and I'm going to wait until the end of this round.
Oh, I got you. Okay. So, Alec.
And up the ladder, let me roll a d20.
I'm positive that your acrobatics is enough. Roll me a pass fail.
There are no words.
Okay, you make it.
Let me just check. Athletics
level
is 5.
3.
Yeah. Athletics is 5. So yeah, I make it. Okay, good. Ah, Malik.
He's behind me. 2 spaces or 1 space. So I'm going to just do the simple thing and throw my hand axe. Catch it up and take my move. Without even checking to see if I killed it.
You absolutely killed it.
It's a minion.
Okay. He's dead.
He's very dead.
Hey, Bite.
All right.
It's gone. Okay. Ellenway is gone. Khaled goes. 1, 2, 3, 4. And the 20. He makes it. Okay. And the next turn, this is the end of a turn. Oh, it's Galan's turn now.
Actually, I'm going to stay here because I don't quite trust Malik to just leave.
What?
I'm going to stay here because I don't quite trust Malik to just leave.
Don't put ideas in his head, Dave. He might use them.
Okay, so end of the turn. and the water level is now up to here. And that door, of course, slams shut. Orcs start to scream from this area here, but of course that area is probably flooded, so you wouldn't be able to hear it anyways. And I guess Galan's going to hold off his turn until after Malix?
Yep.
Okay.
Okay, waste a turn arguing about who's going next.
How about if you both roll me a pass-fail to see if you can climb the ladder? Because that'll end the turn regardless.
Yeah!
I guess Malik goes.
And Galan, the ladder falls down, he can't get it back up. It snapped in half. The end. Poor Galan, we'll remember him. What? Our brave leader died by boiling in with
Galan,
a bunch of
I guess,
orcs because
to
he
stick
broke
around
the ladder.
And watch the last two doors slam shut. The water falls to this, or rises to this level. Oh, yeah, that's the right button.
Galan's up now.
Okay, Okay, good enough. So that'll end it for us all.
Yes!
Okay. So everyone escapes. And you're now... You hear
press
orcs.
The button!
Okay, so two things for that out-of-context D&D thing. How much... What's the die on a thrown orc and boiled Orog? Out of context D&D, gotta love it.
Yeah, it's pretty awesome.
It is.
Okay, so yeah, someone I'm guessing pushes the button.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
What button?
Oh, there's a button in this room that's right beside this stone trap door. And whoever pushes it, whether it be Khaled or one of you guys, as soon as it's pushed, the door slams shut. And just as it's coming down, you can hear orcs that would have been coming in.
Boiling to death?
Do what?
Boiling to death?
Yeah, the orcs came in right here. But... they don't have time to make it to the thing before the water level rises to the top, and they boil to death also. So,
how much XP do we get from all this mess?
Oodles.
I imagine level 12.
Oodles.
Okay. So I'm gonna
fuck ton.
Let me do a little bit of minor rearranging here to cover for everybody that's been killed. Put them all into the dead area.
So many minions!
If anybody wants to see this, this is where I'm moving things to.
Jesus. In other words, out the window.
So last I checked, I had over 10,000, 11,000 DXP, 11,629. But that was last I had it written down. I don't know if that's right.
Mine last written down was 10,663.
Mine
last written was 10,811, but I know that I missed some.
I missed some too.
I don't know if I missed any of the campaign, any of this campaign. I was going to because I quit for a bit.
I don't
but
think anybody's missed any of the campaign. So.
I think 10 would. 11, yeah, it was 11,629 is what I have. So this encounter added into that would be how much?
Well,
so now I haven't added
I'm
it.
I'm not really sure, because I'm thinking that all of these in my graveyard here are from this one map.
Yeah.
I don't think we've totaled up experience since we started this map, have we?
Not that I know of.
I don't think so. No, we haven't.
Okay, so everything in the dead area is going to count then.
Good God.
That's a lot of experience.
And I'm just moving everybody over to the dead area, or into their correct locations. Let's see. Doobie doobie doop boop 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 boop.
Oh, I just realized we should have a ton of XP.
I just realized we could have farmed forever for XP on these little these dudes. They just would have kept coming out. And for XP, if we hadn't hit that hadn't hit the lever, damn it. Oh well. Man, Matt would scold me. We must have had a great chance to EXP farm. Oh well. There are worse fates than not having EXP farmed for everything.
That is true.
There's a couple of these guys are here.
And these archer guys.
Over where?
Okay. So there we go. Anybody who wants to tally that up?
Rathi.
Yeah?
Those two.
Which two? Oh, there's one that doesn't belong.
And here's another.
Tell me again?
So, Tavi can math it. I'll be back in a sec, okay? I want to get food.
Food actually sounds good for me also.
Okay, show me what I missed.
So I'll be right back, gonna grab something to eat, and I will have my mic
them, actually.
And camera
off.
We
while
killed
I'm
exactly 50 minions.
Wow.
Yeah.
So I will be right back.
Yep, that's 50.
That's our total XP for this map.
$6,400?
Yep. I added it all up.
That looks right.
So divide by 5. How many people are in this party?
5, I think.
Yes, 5. So that would be how much we each get.
Yep, $1,280 for each person. For this one encounter. Well, dungeon area.
One, nine. Ah!
What was that?
Assuming Colin has the correct value for our XP before this map, we're 91 XP away from leveling.
What?
If Colin has the right value for our XP before starting this map, we're 91 XP away from leveling.
I still didn't hear that. Ha! I have to go to the bathroom again, and I gotta move this onslaught of fur from my lap. Okay. You can't see it, but it's there, trust me. You got puppy and two kittens. dog and two cats.
I'm sure they're adorable.
But I have to get up, and then we'll have to portion out some experience.
Okay. So,
okay.
Hey. I'm back.
Hello.
Three.
I am going to mute my mic and my camera while I'm eating. Mm-hmm. So I will do that right now.
Kitty. All right, I'm back.
Colin, I kind of hope that you have the wrong value for RXP.
Why?
Because if your value is correct, we are now 91 XP away from leveling.
I'm pretty sure we... Can we just have the 91 XP? I think that was worth it.
To the bathroom.
91 XP, oh my god.
Yeah, that's like two minions and change.
We should have farmed for the damn minions. We should have.
Yeah.
Oh well, I think Rathy will just give it to us. Honestly, that was a pretty epic fight.
Yeah.
What with the orc throwing and the Orokai knocking off into the boiling water, that was just crazy.
Although, I'm not really good at changing my worksheet for my character.
Yeah, I'm not sure how we do that either. I think Doug's going to do that for us, because Doug is the one with the program.
Thank you.
I don't know, Ryan. You'll have to ask Doug, but I think that's how what he said he'd do. Previously, I could be wrong.
I'll just let him do everything, if you don't mind. Mm-hmm.
So we'd get to level 8, correct?
If Freppy gives us the 91 XP we need to level.
I mean, I don't know when I last edited this file, actually. I really don't.
Well, if you
it says... I don't know if that's right. It might actually be less. I don't know. 9/19/2014 is when it was last edited. I don't know which session, how many sessions ago that was.
There's probably just one or two.
That one, we might not even get that far. Should we just say the 91 experience and leave it like that? I think we deserve a level after that shit. That's just me, though. What do you think, Tavi? Were you listening to anything I said?
Not really.
Okay, good. Forgot I said anything. 91 XP. That's all we need. Right?
If you have the right number.
Well, I don't know if I have the right number. And if I don't have the right number, I don't know which direction the right number is off in. If I have more or less than that. Because that might have been more before we reached this area. But it might have been after. And I don't know is the problem. I don't know how many sessions back that was. So should we just... I think we should just kind of go with, like... I don't know. We'll see what Rethi says. I think this would be a good place to level, so Rethi probably will give us the... I don't know. Hey, Rethi.
Hey, I'm back.
So according to Tavi's math... You want to say it, Tavi?
I already told her.
Yeah. He said that you were up to 91 from leveling.
Can we just have that? It's like 2 minions and change.
Well, shouldn't we all be at the same XP?
Yes. I think.
Why is Doug at a lower level?
Doug's not at a lower level, is he?
He's saying in the chat that he's still about 1,000 to level.
Oh, right, because he was... He was away once or twice. I honestly think we should just all get to level 8 this time, because this was like the end of the campaign, and no one's off by that much except for maybe Doug. I don't know.
You're suggesting that we throw in the exact number of XP, and instead we each get just enough to level us to level 8. Is that right?
Yeah, well, basically.
I still have to give out experience bonuses. Kitten, don't bite my chin.
So experience bonuses, like for what?
Well, like for things well done, like Dash throwing an orc at another orc.
Or my knocking the thing into the boiling pit.
Right.
And double attack.
Everybody did a lot of really cool stuff during this campaign. Mm-hmm. I'm going to make it a fair... like, just a fair bonus of, you know, giving you all the same amount kind of thing so that you can be kind of same
bonus,
area.
Right.
I may even have to give Faebite a little bit of extra just so that he catches up, because it wasn't his fault that he was corrupted and wasn't able to fight, considering that it was probably, I think it was external influences anyways. So, let me think. Doug, how much over 1,000 do you need?
Doug?
I think he's got his hands full. Okay, so... Yeah. That's an awful lot to miss out on because you weren't there. Objectively speaking, would you say that Faebite might have learned something from his experience as corrupted? Actually, I do know that he did the one thing that had where he basically
fired himself,
exploded into a ball of green fire.
Yeah, there was that.
Yeah, there was that.
And he was involved in that, so... Or that... That would be some... Yeah. Green fire thing was his idea, he says. So, So I'm just trying to think, why don't we just, call everyone level 8.
Okay.
I like this plan.
As do I.
Do what?
Like the plan. He likes this plan, he says. I already know what I'm going to do for my character, at least, except for the feat. I need to figure out which feat I want to take.
Okay. If that seems fair to everybody, then that would be fair to me, because that way nobody falls behind. That's one thing I don't want to happen, no matter what else is going on, is to have anybody fall behind, because it's not always the character's fault that they miss a fight. Sometimes it's an out-of-world scenario where you basically have no choice. So I think that would be considered fair to not leave Fabite out of the experience. Ooh. Not leave Fabite out of the experience just because his player wasn't able to make it that day. So, yeah, if everyone thinks that's fair to do, maybe call it 100 over the next level. Because you all did some really cool stuff. So, 191 for everybody except Doug, and then Doug would get... Well, that's not the right button presses regardless, but, yay, I typed good today. So, Doug, Fabite gets 1,157, because that'll push him to 100 over experience, and everyone else gets 191. Sound fair?
Okay, we're all level 8.
Anyone who opposes?
That works.
That's fine, Doug. I don't know when we'll be able to play next. Hopefully soon, but you'll have plenty of time, I'm sure. I know that this next coming week, my schedule is, well, pretty much full because I have Christmas Eve and Christmas Day off, and no one's going to want to play on... That's like tomorrow and the next day. So I'm going to be working Wednesday through Tuesday. Or... No, wait. Friday through Tuesday next week. And I may end up not getting a day off till next Thursday, because that's how the scheduling works sometimes. So I don't know what she's going to do for that. Maybe I'll probably have another 9-day week. But whatever. We'll figure that out when we get to it. Anyway, there's hungry people, and go ahead and finish off the last of this thing. It doesn't actually say what happens next. So I'm going to have to wing it.
We could just wait till next time.
We could wing it next time, yeah. Let's just say this. So at the end of this ordeal, everybody makes it out, and the orcs end up being trapped on the other side of the pipes. Orcs, you know, that you arrive home safely. There's no fighting, because obviously all the fighting was coming from those tunnels, and they're not coming back anymore. So the escape hatch actually leads right to the very top, and you're able, or at top of the temple, it goes out, and you're able to head down the mountains with no trouble at all. You get back to the town, which I'll go ahead and bring that up if I can find it. Was it Overlook? I think it was. Yes, it was Overlook. So, boom. Let's put this back on screen share really fast. Okay. So, just real fast wrap up of what's going on. You make
yes.
it back to Overlook, and you head to the tavern that you were at before. I can't remember what it's called. And you walk through to you come in from this area here to a hero's welcome, and they want to show you around the town, and they want to give you, you know, everyone wants to be happy and have spent and give you a throw-your parade, and you say, or you guys probably would decide that you're just flat out too tired and you're done. You want to be, you want to go to bed, and you'll wake up in the morning and deal at that point.
So, Mal would probably be okay with parade.
Yeah, because that was a pretty grueling fight, and it took 3 episodes to get through it. That's saying a lot. So, 3 episodes, and that's all in the course of 1 game day. I think you're probably worn out, and Malik, or not, is it Malik? No, it was, what's his name?
Are you thinking of Khaled?
Yeah, Khaled would definitely agree. He leads you all back to, not the barracks, but like the guest quarters. Specifically the guest part of the part of the guest quarters that would be visiting royalty. And you go into the bedrooms. You each have your own bedroom to yourself. It's massive inside, and you just, you know, hot baths, hot meals, and warm beds for everybody, and you crash like you haven't slept in weeks. So let's end it there.
Okay.
Right. Okay.
Sounds
that's
good.
Fair to me, at least. Yeah, you fall asleep like you haven't slept in days, and you're out for a good 36 hours straight.
I probably wake up sooner than that because I'm drow, and also because. Sorry, what?
Do what?
When we get the information on scheduling next week, I'll get in touch with everybody, and we'll see what works.
Okay.
Okay.
I'm actually missing some. Speaking again, but let's see if there was anybody who decided to watch and ask a question. Probably not. I've got 0 viewers. Okay. Anyway, let's call that. Let's wrap it up for the night, because I know we haven't eaten anything yet today, and it's probably about that time. So. I'd like to thank everybody for watching. Episode 20 will show up whenever we have a chance to film it, and that'll be starting a new campaign, so yay for that, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. Anyway, we'll talk to you all next time. Thanks for stopping by. We'll set up another time whenever we have a chance. I don't know when that'll be, but hopefully soon. Yeah. Take care.
Okay. Bye, all.
Bye.
Bye.